It's an A-log. Hi, I'm C1 Conceity Films. It's an A-log. Now, the reason why I'm doing an A-log this week, because I made a really big edited vlog on my birthday, in case you guys haven't already checked it out. So there's nothing to show on camera, plus there's loads to discuss about this week, so I thought I'd just do an A-log. Now, in case you haven't already checked out on Major Nelson's blog lately, plus not only that, there's been some other things that are coming on Xbox Live and all that, so I'm going to say some deals and releases that'll be coming out. Now, this week's deal of the week, I've already checked it out, and this finishes until next Tuesday. They've got two Bulletstorm DLCs, a Red Faction Battlegrounds arcade game, also some price drop on some Tom Clancy Splinter Cell Conviction DLC, and also the Xbox Live Arcade Hydrophobia, and they're all 400 Microsoft points until next Tuesday. And next week's deal of the week, next week on the following Tuesday, will be Guilty Gear on Xbox Live Arcade for 400 Microsoft points, a Xbox original of Metal Arms, which will be 800 Microsoft points, a Bioshock 2 DLC for 400 Microsoft points, and also a Borderlands DLC for 400 Microsoft points. So that's next week on Tuesday. And on this following Wednesday, coming out at August 31st, in case any of you guys still play Pinball FX2, there will be a table for Miss Explosion Man. I did say on my Miss Explosion Man trial gameplay that I did say that I'll purchase and do some gameplay of. So I will be purchasing that table, show you some gameplay of it, and that will be 240 Microsoft points. The table will cost, and it's surprisingly that the whole entire thing is free, but the tables do cost you. It's like game room anyways. Also, I know most of you Sonic fans heard about this, but in case any of you guys have never heard of it, Sonic CD will be coming on XBLA and plus PlayStation Network coming up soon. Not so sure when, but it's playable in PAX, in case you guys are going to PAX, you know, and all that. And in case you guys have a Xbox 360, there'll be two exclusive DLCs for Skyrim for 30 days exactly, and then it'll be on PC and PS3 afterwards. So is any of you guys going to get an Xbox 360? Yeah, I know I will. I know most of you can't wait for Modern Warfare 3, just don't turn on me, but there will be some Avatar gear, which will be coming up at September 2nd. Also, if you can't get enough of Call of Duty these days, Activision will be doing a sale on games on demand, plus add-ons and much, much more on a Activision sale that they will be doing at August 30th to September 5th. I do not know if they'll do any Guitar Hero type things, but we'll see. Also on Xbox Live Arcade, in case you haven't already found out, Street Fighter 3 Third Strike Online, whatever it's called, that's been out recently on my birthday on August 24th. Also, in case you're not interested in Street Fighter and you want a bit more Mortal Kombat-y, the Mortal Kombat Arcade Collection will be coming out at August 31st as well. In case you had enough of Fruit Ninja or 100% the achievements like I did, yeah, I recently 100% the achievements on Fruit Ninja Kinect. There is a really cool little Kinect game called Hole in the Wall. It's really fun, like the Japanese TV shows where people go through holes and try and fit through them. It's quite fun. I do recommend downloading the trial and see what you think of yourselves. It's quite fun. And that's also been released on my birthday at August 24th. Also, I know that PSN had this, but it's now on Xbox Live now, and that is Castle Crasher DLC. Now, they got the Pink Knight DLC, and that's a free pack you can actually download. Also, there is another DLC, which is a blacksmith pack, where blacksmith is actually a knight and you go out and help people, and that's also out, and that's 160 Microsoft points. So yeah, loads of Castle Crashers stuff lately, I don't know why, even though it is a really old game. Speaking of old games, I want to discuss about another topic, and that is Halo Fest. Now, Halo Fest has recently been happening since the PAX events, the Penny Arcade Expo that's been happening in America at the moment, and there's been loads of cool announcements that have been happening on Halo Fest that I'll be saying about now. Now, Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary will be coming out soon, and there have been announcements on what they'll be doing on it even more. It'll be supported in 3D, which is cool, plus they added some new maps, and plus one map that used to be on the PC release, and that will be on the Halo Anniversary Edition, which will be cool, coolios, and all that. And for your Halo Reach people out there, there will be another title update, and they've been saying like all loads of stuff about, you know, lock armor, this, that, and the other, that they'll be tweaking this. And also Magnum from Halo 1 or something like that I heard on the internet that they would be returning on Halo Reach. Also, in case you can't wait for Halo 4 to come out, in case you are going to purchase Forza 4, they are going to do a special sneak peek at a first look at the Halo 4's Warhog, I can't speak today. It's a shame that you can't actually play the car, but you can actually use the, you know, the Kinect features on Forza 4, and also you can just have a look at the car and get more information about the new Warhog for Halo 4, which is kind of interesting for those people that purchase Forza 4. Anyways, enough about Halo. Speaking about cars, you know, like the DeLorean that they put on Forza 3, the Back to the Future game will be featured on the retail release. It's a shame they're really not going to put on Xbox 360 because not much people demanded it to be on Xbox 360. I did say on a vlog one time that if most people get demanded to put on Xbox 360, they would do it, but sadly they didn't. But they are going to do a retail release of the Back to the Future game on Nintendo Wii and plus PlayStation 3. It'll be $20 in America, but I'm not so sure if there'll be any sort of release in the UK as of what I can read on the internet. Okay, take a breather from that. I just want to give out a shout out. Now, the reason why I want to give out the shout out, because it has been, you know, so nice to me throughout, you know, Facebook and plus the YouTube comments. And yeah, now and I kind of talked to him now again, and I recently re-added him on Xbox Live and such, because he used to be on my backup account on my Xbox Live account. And I want to give a shout out to PSP Cool Kid, Marcus, if you're listening right now. I'd like to thank you for giving me 400 Microsoft points for my birthday, which was very nice to use. I would put it towards Hydrophobia, but I didn't feel like putting it towards Hydrophobia. And also gave me information about that Castle Crashers. Also, not only that, with the new DLCs came out, they also have an Avatar Awards as well, as you may have saw on the intro and plus on my Avatar thing as well. So I'd like to thank you for that. Thank you for the Microsoft points and plus the information for me to say in my A-log. Now let's move over to mobile stuff. Now recently I regret on buying it, and now I regret myself for buying it, but I don't give a damn anyways. Recently I bought Sims 3 for the Windows Phone 7. There have been like reviews on it saying that the save feature doesn't work properly, and I regret myself on buying it now, and I'm now one of them complaint people that the save feature does not work. But it doesn't bother me if the save feature doesn't work. I just reload it now and again and trying to get a few achievements here and there. Also, not only that, The Sims 3 for Windows Phone 7 is the same as the iOS version. And recently I got the free iOS version, which is Sims 3 World Explorers, that I recently got for free, that my sister would be pleased of, because she really wanted Sims 3 on her iPod, and now it's on more so on my iPod because we both share accounts. Speaking about freebies, even though that I did say on my last vlog about Rage HD being free, but now that's gone and done with, it's now, you know, £1.50 now instead of free now. But in case any of you guys still want a freebie, recently they did Doodle Jump for free, but there's like a free version. Now this free version is the same as the full version, but it has little ads, you know, and all that, like they usually do on a free version. But it's cool that they finally did a free light version of Doodle Jump, which took them a while, I guess. But yeah, there's a freebie for use for you guys to download. Another recent freebie that's been happening that I was super psyched for when I found out it finally came out in the UK, and it's Minesweep. Now, Minesweeper, that I did mention on a few vlogs ago, that it would never come to the UK, but now and again, it finally came to the UK, and it came out on my birthday at August 24. So in case you guys have a Windows Phone 7 in hand, in case you'd want a freebie, then Minesweep is another free game for you for the Windows Phone 7, and plus now that it has some achievements here and there, and it's nice, really nice, for a freebie for Windows Phone 7. Also, another freebie that's going to be happening later on exclusively for the iPads. Now, funny you should say, Bungie, you know, the people that make Halo games, now now not doing Halo games anymore and decided to do other things. Bungie Aerospace, who is the which is the mobile owned company sort of thing, they are doing an exclusive game for the iPad, and the first chapter will be for free. Recently, that I recently found out, which is Crimson Pirate. Game. It's basically an RTS pirate game, some kind of thing, but it's going to be free, and knowing me, I haven't got an iPad, so I won't be particularly reviewing it, but however, someone is. That's why I'm going to give out a shout out. I'm going to give a shout out to Apple Gamer 24/7, because he recently gave a shout out to me on his vlog, because I gave him a link about this Bungie game, and he's a bit of a Halo fan as well as I am, and because it was for the iPad, exclusive for the iPad, I thought it'd be interesting, and he wanted to say thanks on his vlog, so I wanted to give him a shout out back, and he said he was going to do a review, so do check out his channel, and some point later on next week he'll do a review for you guys for it. Speaking about iOS, iPads, iPods, this, that, and the other, I bet you guys are wondering about my thoughts about Steve Jobs re-signing on different regimes as chairman. My thoughts on it is not entirely my sort of topic to discuss about. Sure, the only Apple product that I have is an iPod, and it's the only Apple product that I ever had, plus an iPod Shuffle and all that. But still, however, it doesn't kind of concern me unless I'm a really big Apple fag or whatever like that. Whatever you like to call it, a Mac fag. I don't know what you call it. But, you know, an Apple fanboy or anything like that, because I don't have any big Apple products or anything like that. So it doesn't concern me. But I hope Steve Jobs does well as chairman, and hope the company does well and such like that. So anyways, what I've been up to lately, not as much. Recently, I've been having my birthday lately. You haven't already checked out on my birthday vlog that I recently did. It saves me saying it on my A-log. This is why I'm doing a big discussion on my A-log right now. Also, know that I've been playing Cam's copy of Prince of Persia Forgotten Sands, and it's a really good game, I do admit, because I don't usually play much of Prince of Persia games, but by it, that was a really good game, because I'm still carrying on playing it as of now, and I'm up to, was it thanks to that, it gave me a gamer score boost up to, 41k and all that, which is kind of good, so I'd like to thank Cam for that. You know, overall, the Prince of Persia game, I do recommend. It's one of those games that you kind of get into addictively, and like Cammy did it in a day, but I don't think I can complete in like a day, but still it's a really good game. Also, lately for me, I've been having an ear infection, because for some reason during the course after my birthday, after the Wednesday, August 24th, for some reason my ears started blocking up and I kind of got an infection, so I can't basically hear as much, so I've been deafened, something like that, half deaf lately. But it was quite funny, because when I walked into town, it sounded all monotone-y. It's like I had headphones in, but I didn't have headphones in, because my ears were blocked and stuff, which is kind of funny, which is not, but still, yeah, I've been having infection lately, but it should be recovering after next week, maybe. Speaking about next week, let's discuss about videos quite quickly. Now, the videos that I'll be working on so far will be just be the Miss Explosion Man pinball FX2 table gameplay, whatever, the DLC content that will be coming out August 31st, which I'll be doing. Also, with that, I'll be recently going back to work next week-ish on Friday at September 2nd, so I'll be going back to work, and I need to do some how-to videos before I go back to work, so I'll be busy on that. But overall, yeah, life has been great, so I'm looking forward to going back to work, getting job pays and all that. Oh yeah, I recently got my job pay, but it was £0 because I didn't put my timesheets in properly. So all of it will be back up to date, and plus it'll be a big sum before you know it. Oh yeah, also, since it is Saturday 27th of August, Doctor Who will be starting up again, so I'll be watching that. Woo! I can't wait. Doctor Who and all that. I need to watch that tonight at some point during the course of this recording and all that. So I'll be watching that on BBC iPlayer on my PS3 and all that. So anyway, sorry for the very long discussion, long-winded A-log and all that. This is why I kind of do A-log, so I can talk things in one go. And plus, I do edit my audio and all that. So anyways, that is my A-log. So I hope you guys have been updated. Hope you guys really enjoy this A-log. I know it's been a bit boring, but I did say what I need to say, and it saves me saying things. So anyways, hope you really enjoy this A-log, and see you from CG Films. And have a nice weekend, guys.